Hey Wildcats, and welcome to Chapel. I'm Camille Soileau.
And I'm Kai Stone. Here's a look at this week's Wildcat Weekly Minute.
Attention students, be prepared to receive a special alert this Wednesday from FEMA and the FCC. It's a test of the iPulse system, which alerts the public in case of a national emergency. You'll get the alert around 1:20 Wednesday afternoon if your phone is on. It will say this is a test of the National Wireless Emergency Alert System. No action is needed.
The Miss LCU pageant is happening this Thursday. This event is a culture credit, so make sure to stop by to support these LCU women. General admission is $10, but LCU students, faculty, and staff can get a tickets for only $5.
The ASL Club is hosting weekly meetings on Monday at 7:30 p.m. in Impact Room 206. Stop by to learn more about this club.
Are you interested in becoming a Wildcat Navigator? Apply today using the QR code on the screen. The code will also be in the Wildcat Weekly.
Open house hours for this semester have been announced. Open house is from 6 p.m. until 10 p.m. Monday and Wednesday through Saturday, and from 8 p.m. until 10 p.m. on Tuesday. There are no open house hours on Sunday. Make sure you are familiar with the open house policy in the student handbook before inviting a guest into the dorms. Please check in with the RA at the front desk of your dorm or contact the RA on duty to check in a guest.
Wildcat Catholics meet on Thursdays at 11 in the library conference room. This October, they are reflecting on the Rosary.
Now let's throw it to Noel Schonhoff with Wildcats Media Sports for a look at what's going on in Wildcat Athletics.
What's up, Wildcats? October is here and so is fall. Kind of like what our opponents are doing, falling to the LCU Wildcats. Let's get you caught up. Did you say longest win streak in the state of Louisiana? Well, football earned it. They are now 4-0 in the SAC and 5-0 overall and 12-0 dating back to last season. The Wildcats handled business, defeating the Oklahoma Panhandle State 29-17. Levi Hilborn earned Special Teams Player of the Week and LCU Male Athlete of the Week for his performance against the Aggies. These men will be back home this Saturday at 2 p.m. for a non-conference matchup against the North American Stallions. Women's soccer took home 2 wins, 2 hat tricks, and a total of 18 goals this past week. First defeating the Jarvis Christian 3-1, then Texas College 15-0. These women continue to mow through the conference play and are now sitting at 5-0 in conference and 7-1 overall. These Wildcats will take a road trip to Texarkana to play the Eagles on Thursday at 1 p.m., then continue to Shreveport to face the Pilots on Saturday at 1 p.m. as well. Men's soccer also added 2 wins to their belt, beating Jarvis Christian 2-1. Then Texas College 8-0. These men have moved to 5-0 in conference and 6-2-1 overall. The men will hit the road with the ladies and compete against the Eagles on Thursday following the women, and then on Saturday against the Pilots following the women's game. Women's volleyball came back and went 1-1 this weekend, dropping the first game to Houston Tillotson, then defeating them the next day. Emma Cother won herself another Player of the Week award for the RRAC and LCU, and is sitting at third in the RRAC for assists. Volleyball will host Paul Quinn on Friday at 7 p.m., then Saturday at noon for Senior Day. Women's tennis competed for the first time this past week and are still continuing to build and grow the new program. Although the outcome wasn't what they wanted, they will be back in 2 weeks to compete again on October 20th in New Orleans at the Dillard Invitational. To keep up with scores and updates, check out www.lcwildcats.net. For all things LCU sports, I'm Noel Schonhoff. Back to you guys at the desk.
Thanks, Noel. If you need anything to be announced in a Wildcat Minute, please email wildcatweekly@lcuuniversity.edu 2 weeks before the event so we can make an announcement in a timely manner.
Be sure to follow us at Wildcats Media on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter to keep up with our Wildcats Media News team during the semester.
For Wildcats Media News, I'm Kai Stone.
And I'm Camille Swallow.
I'll see you later.